The detention of Benhur Luy sparked what could be the biggest corruption investigation in the country's history. It all began with a falling out between relatives, allegedly involved in defrauding government of billions of pesos. This report.
It was in 2013 when Arturo and Gertrudes Luy asked Justice Secretary Leila De Lima for help. They said their son, Benhur, was being held against his will at a condominium in Taguig City. The National Bureau of Investigation conducted a rescue operation and recovered Benhur from a unit owned by her relative, Janet Lim Napoles. After the rescue, all hell broke loose. It was then that the public would begin to uncover one of the biggest scams in the country's history. Gertrudes and Benhur had been longtime employees of Janet Napoles, a rags-to-riches businesswoman owning several companies that often deal with the government. Benhur had been Napoles' most trusted staff. He was involved in nearly every transaction in the Napoles-owned JLN Corporation, especially those involving government funds. Many of these dealings are said to be illegal, involving kickbacks from congressional pork allocations worth billions of pesos. Sometime in 2012, Napoles suspected Benhur of dealing with government officials on his own. Toward the latter part of December that year, Gertrudes and her family lost contact with Benhur. In January, Gertrudes was allowed to see Benhur twice through Napoles' brother, Jojo Lim. She says Benhur was able to slip her a note saying he was indeed being held against his will. Benhur's parents, fearing for their son's life, had to go to the DOJ, despite supposedly being warned by Jojo Lim not to involve anyone, especially the authorities, and keep the matter within the family. After being rescued and placed under the Witness Protection Program, Benhur filed cases of serious illegal detention against Napoles and her brother. Napoles' defense lawyers insisted Benhur was never held against his will, presenting several witnesses to support their claim. At one point, they said Benhur was being rehabilitated. He was supposedly a drug addict. They even submitted an affidavit supposedly signed by several priests staying at a housing facility where Benhur was also made to stay. The affidavit says Benhur never asked for help, nor did he mention he was being prevented from leaving. The prosecution denied the defense's claims. But aside from the detention case, Benhur had other plans. He came out to testify against Napoles on the 10 billion peso pork barrel scam, which started legal and legislative investigations, putting a number of lawmakers and other government officials under the spotlight. In August 2013, Napoles surrendered to President Aquino. More than 2 years after this saga began, the court found Napoles guilty of illegally detaining Benhur Luy. She remains detained at Camp Bagundiwa pending her transfer to the Women's Correctional Facility. Her brother remains at large.